Amityville, It's About Time is the, was it, the sixth movie in the Amityville franchise, and it is a much better improvement than the last one, because that last one was ass, okay? This one, however, is the early 90s, basically, and it's a little bit kind of light in tone, but you can still tell that this movie is R-rated, and it still creeps you the fuck out a little bit. And the plot of It's About Time is we meet this man who has a girlfriend who has another boyfriend, basically. And he brings home this mysterious clock, of course, from the Amityville house. Okay? Not knowing it is inhabited by demonic spirits. So, weird shit starts happening, basically, as a whole, because of it. And it affects him, I believe his son, and his girlfriend. This movie is good. I liked it. I actually enjoyed this movie, because it is creepy when it needs to be creepy, but when it's actually trying to set the tone for the movie, it's kind of lighthearted. And I don't mean like PG-13 is horror movie lighthearted. No. I'm talking about like life goes on a little bit. It seems like more like you get in a happier mood before shit starts getting the fan. It's not so gritty like the first movie, but when it wants to go there, it'll go there. And that's what I like about this movie, you know what I mean? And a clock seems a lot, I don't know why a clock seems a lot more better than a demonic lamp than in the last movie, but for some weird ass reason, I like that part better. I don't know why they decided to go with a lamp for the last movie and made it look like a person. That's kind of weird, but yeah. But the clock was the better choice, because clocks are fun and all, but there's one aspect of a clock that's annoying. I think you all know what it is. The ticking. And the clock ticks all the fucking time, to the point where it even annoys the girlfriend when she's in the bed trying to sleep, because it's trying to make weird shit go on, pretty much. So, yeah. Acting in the movie is solid. I mean, I don't know the main guy. I really don't know anybody in this movie. They're all mostly unknown people that you don't see anymore. Or they probably just had this one movie and that was it. So, but they were actually decent unknown people. I never really watched a movie with a bunch of unknown people before. Unless it's something I really want to see or something I have to review. Then I would do that. But every now and then, I come across a movie with unknown people that's actually good. Take case in point, Chronicle. Pretty much. The only person I actually knew from that movie was Michael B. Jordan and Miles Teller. That's about it. Not Miles Teller. Michael B. Jordan. Miles Teller. What the fuck am I doing? This ain't Fantastic Four. Oh my god. That movie's etched in my fucking head. Anyway. Any fucking way. Where was I? Oh, it's about time. It's about time we got a good Amityville movie, okay? Not since the first fucking two. You know, that was what? Three movies ago now? Because the third one sucked. Fourth one sucked. Fifth one sucked. Here we are, the sixth movie. The sixth movie is now the Star Trek franchise. Because the sixth movie was the best one. While five sucked cock. Same goes for this one. Six is good, five suck dick. That's funny. We actually even got a couple of pairs of titties in this movie, so that's another plus of It's About Time. But overall though, Amityville, It's About Time, is a decent horror flick, and it's about damn time. Pun intended, because it took three damn movies. Seriously, I was getting ready to say, you're turning into Hellraiser faster than hell itself. But anyways, I will give Amityville, It's About Time, a B. Let me know what you guys think about Amityville, It's About Time down below. Did you like it? Did you hate it? Oh, what do we got? Like 7 or 8 movies left from 14? I hope so, because we're on the 7th film now. Let's do this.